Welcome at tutorial number 14 of the EEP10 Model Railway Simulator. In this video we are going to have a look at how we can create routes and assign routes to a train in order to send it to a certain location that we defined. Let's open up the program and see how we can accomplish that. I already have the program opened, and if you have been working with me, we can load the video, the end result of tutorial 13 via the open file menu here. This is the end result of 13. What we did over there, we are working in general on anti-collision security. We don't want our trains to ever bump into each other. So we're trying to find ways to avoid that. And what we did at Station South is we have here the entry switch. And we placed some sensors in the rail over here, such that when the diesel lock of the passenger train runs over the sensor, the switch goes to track 1. And if the steam engine runs over this sensor, then this switch switches to track 2. And that way we don't have to worry about Station South. There will never be a collision as long as we keep this in place. At Station North, I would like to do something similar, but in a different way. We are going to work with routes. What is a route? It is just a name that you can give to a certain direction and a certain path to work to go to via the switches that we are going to control with that route. Let's first define the routes, and that can be done in the menu that is called Vaarstrekken. And then the first entry is Vaarstrekken bearbeiten, that is, let's say, edit routes. Well, there is not much to edit. In fact, all I can do is name my routes. And well, I'd like to define two routes in this video, for Station North track 1 and Station North track 2. So let me just give them easy to remember name. North 01, that is a route I want to have. Click the add button and let's enter also North 02, and again click the add button. Well, you don't see much happening. Well, what we did is just give two routes a name and they are now saved as under that name. Now we have to define our routes. That means which switches do we want to throw depending on the route. Well, this is our Station North and here are the entry switches. Let's zoom in a bit and let's decide together that in order to have a train that comes from here drive to track North 1, all we need to do is have this switch in this direction. Yeah, let me zoom in a bit. This switch is now such that the train goes to track 1. I right click on it and read what it says. It stays there only for half a second. Read fast. It says Richtung Vaart. That is what we have to remember, because now we can place a sensor over here that throws the switch in Richtung Vaart. Okay, let's do that. We click the signal icon over here and then we have to take care in the drop-down list that we have selected Weiche, which is German for a junction switch or a turnout. And then I click the turnout and you see my cursor change and I can now place a sensor over here. Well, that's good. And now let's right click it and we are going to fill this menu in. We only need it for direction 1, so I click away number 2. And over here you see, which route do you want it to work on? Well, we have defined two routes. Here they are, North 1 and North 2. That's why we defined those routes, so that they come available in this list. Well, I am going to work now on North 1. And what we needed is for this switch to go to Vaart. And I think we have set everything correct, so we can click OK. Now what we need to do is take care what the actions are for North 2, which is this track over here. And well, I can see that I need to have this switch in this direction and this switch in that direction. Let's right click them to see how they are called now. Abzweig, and also that one is Abzweig. Okay, good to know. Let's go to the Weigre sensor mode again. Well, that is already done, of course. We never changed that. And I'm going again to this switch over here and place another sensor for it and right click it. Valid for direction 1. Route now is north 2. And the direction is Abzweig. Okay. And then we have to do the same for this switch number 5. I try to click in the neighborhood of it and then hope that everything is okay. And I can check if I did it right by looking over here what it says. Yes, it says junction 5, so we are on the right track here. Again, for route north 2, we want to set it to Abzweig. I think we did everything what we needed to do. Let's go to 3D mode and see if we can assign these routes to our trains. How can you assign a route? Well, that's rather easy. I can click my engine. Let's do the diesel engine first, the passenger train. Go to automatic mode and over here you have the drop down which says which routes are available. And let's have this one go to north 1. And I will set it free by shift clicking its signal, and there it goes. In the meantime, I can click the steam engine and click auto mode and send it to north 2. And against all safety regulations, I let it go also. Let's have a look what this guy over here is doing. Yes, it is going to track 1. That was because it follows route north 1. Okay, I will release it over here again so that we can make another round. In the meantime, this guy should be going to north 2. Yes, it still says north 2. So let's see if we build all those switches correct. And then it should go to lane number 2. Well, it seems to have worked. Yes, we did a good job. We can pat ourselves on the shoulder. Okay, here is my station, my diesel again on station south. Let's click it and let's now send it to north 2. Why not? Well, there's a problem. The steam engine is still there, so we need to be careful, but I'm going to make some fun. There it goes, and hopefully I can just in time have my steam lock out of there. So you see, we have now been trying to avoid collisions by giving the trains different routes, but we can still make mistakes. So this protection is still not good enough. What can we do more? Well, for instance, what we could do is build a real secure signaling system, which is called the block signaling. And that is what we are going to have a look at in the next video. What I would like to show you now is that this route system is more flexible than what we did at Station South. It's more flexible because I can send any train to any route. I can now send my steam lock to North 1, and if I release it, it will go there. So working with routes is much more flexible than what we did at Station South, where we were throwing the switch based on which train runs over it. Now it is Station North based on which route a train has, and since you can assign any route to any train, you can have any train land on any track over here. It would be a good idea to also build routes for track 3 and track 4, but I will do that outside of this video. Well, see you back at video number 15, where we are going to work on block signaling. Let's save this video, this result, under number 14. Oh, our list is growing. I already had a 14. Well, I overwrite it. Yes,